Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're talking about cinematic titles and how to make them for your films using Adobe After Effects. I'm going to be walking you guys through three different title animations and show you guys how to incorporate them into Premiere using the Essential Graphics panel. But before we start, I do want to mention that I'm including these three title animations in the description down below that you guys can go download right now. To start, we're going to hop right into After Effects and create a new composition. To do this, you can either go to the top and click New Composition or do Control N or Command N on your keyboard. For this first example, I'm going to leave the resolution at 1080p and leave the frame rate at 23.976. Next, what I'm going to do is drag and drop my footage into my new composition and create a new title by pressing Control or Command T on my keyboard and start typing out my text in the composition window. For the font, I'm going to choose Montserrat, and I may be butchering that, I apologize, but that is going to be my main font across the three templates that we're making today. For this example, I'm going to keep the font size relatively small at about 50 pixels, and I'm going to set the font style to be bold. After doing this, make sure in the Align tab that your text is vertically and horizontally aligned, and in the Paragraph tab, make sure your text is center aligned. Next, I'm going to create a mask around my text by using the pen tool. To do this, hit G on your keyboard and start clicking around your text. I'm just going to create a pretty simple mask here, but keep it unique enough so the reveal will be interesting to watch. Next, I'm going to go down to my timeline and move my playhead to the 1 second mark. And I'm going to open up my mask properties by hitting the arrow icon, masks, and hit the stopwatch for mask expansion. Then I'm going to jump to the start and create another keyframe by dialing down the mask expansion until my text just starts to disappear. Also, just to make the animation a little cleaner, I'm going to change the mask feather to 46. Now that this first title is finished, I'm going to set it up to work as a template in Adobe Premiere. To do this, go to Window, Essential Graphics, select your composition and create a title for it. I'm just going to type in cinematic title 001. To see what properties you can make editable in Premiere, click Solo Supported Properties, and this will reveal all the properties below in the timeline. For this example, I know I'm only going to want to adjust the title and the color itself. To do this, I'm going to click and drag the source text into the Essential Graphics panel and rename it to Main Title. For the color, I'm going to hit Animate, Fill, Color, then RGB, and change the color to white and drag the fill color into the Essential Graphics panel. This way, once I bring this title into Premiere, I'm going to be able to change the title text as well as the color. Before exporting the title into Premiere, I'm going to delete the footage behind that we brought in initially, so we're only exporting the text. Now we can finally export the title by clicking Export Motion Graphics Template. Save your project and set the destination to be Local Templates Folder. Before I go into Premiere and show you guys how this all works with the Essential Graphics panel, I'm just going to go ahead and create the two other titles. For the second title, we're going to keep the font the exact same as well as the font size. We're only going to adjust the style to be light instead of bold. And I'm going to pull the tracking to be 1000%. This time I'm going to go to about the half second mark and drop an opacity keyframe and jump back to start and make the opacity 0%. Next, I'll double tap the U key and click the button beside animate and select tracking. I'm going to go ahead and press the stopwatch button beside tracking amount to set my first keyframe. I then move along my timeline to about the 6 second mark and move the tracking amount to be 20. Now that we have a nice cinematic movement between the letters, I'm going to do two additional things, which would be adding an animation for the fade out of the text, as well as a little camera blur as the text comes in. To start, let's adjust that opacity by going to the 5 second mark and placing an opacity keyframe. Then move forwards to about the 6 second mark and create another keyframe with opacity at 0%. To add the camera blur, we're going to want to go to the effects panel, type in lens blur, and drag the effect called camera lens blur onto our text layer. I'm going to first create a keyframe at 0 seconds by pressing the blur radius stopwatch button and change the amount to 10. Then scroll on my timeline to about 1 second and change the radius to 0%. All right, now this is looking pretty good. We see that cool little camera blur effect. Now let's create that last title animation. For this one, I used the same font and created a subtle directional blur reveal. To do this, you can simply drag the directional blur effect onto your text and set the blur length to be 14 and move forwards to about 2 seconds and adjust the blur length to be 0. Now to create the look of it moving forwards, I'm just going to play around the scale parameter. To do this, you can press S on your keyboard, and now I'm just going to place down 2 keyframes, one being a little smaller than the other. All right, so now let's head into Premiere and go to Window and Essential Graphics. And we can go ahead and drag the title template that we created earlier into the timeline. And now we can click onto our layer and you're able to change the title itself and the color. If you did decide to download these title templates, you can load them right into Premiere by clicking the Install Motion Templates button in the bottom corner of the Essential Graphics panel. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did learn something new, hit that like button down below. And if you haven't already, subscribe for more videos just like this. Thanks again, guys, for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.